pool of...
This is where
Matty O.W.
unraveled the mysteries of
AIM training.
This is the birthplace of
AIM.
This is Guerria, one of the greatest AIM training players in the world. He was the first to reach the rank of Divinity in the AIM Lab Revosec benchmarks, and is one of the most ambitious grinders that I know. But who is he talking about? According to Guerria, this is fundamentally perfect technique. The form and skill on display here is unlike any other AIM training player. This is Snowi. Snowi is an older kovaaks player and the third place winner of all three kovaaks League competitions in 2022. He is an all-rounder with especially notable runs in dynamic clicking and tracking. At his prime, he was most prominently known for his bounce 180 and air scores. As Guerria mentions, Snowy's smoothness is exceptional. It's almost beautiful, in a way, just that he makes these runs seem perfect. Even if they are not necessarily the highest scores nowadays, they still look better than the more fast, snappy runs. But if Snowy's technique doesn't produce the best possible scores overall, what makes it so good? What makes it significant even now, as the strategies for getting high scores in AIM training have improved? To answer this, we have to ask ourselves about the reasons why most people play AIM training. The most commonly discussed trouble with players in FPS games is inconsistency. Inconsistency plagues all of us in some way. We don't always hit our best shots, and in the AIM Trainer, we can't get world record level scores every single run. But certain techniques in aiming promote consistency better than others by minimizing the amount of wasted movements in our aim and maximizing accuracy or time on target. This is the purpose of aim strategies such as edge tracking. With this in mind, Snowy's technique becomes something that we should all strive for in aiming. But how exactly does it work? High accuracy is one of the main factors that sets Snowy's runs apart. I've since beaten this score, but my run, personally, looks more messy. I have a lower accuracy, and it is only a world record because my hits outnumber Snowy's. Runs showing a high accuracy indicate good consistency. Note, this does not mean that every run Snowy plays will be a good run, but rather it means that each of Snowy's individual motions within this singular run were consistently performed well. Snowy's aim is unique when it is viewed in comparison to other strong runs of aim training scenarios. As we mentioned, his distinguishing factor is his accuracy, which is made most apparent in never-miss scenarios. These scenarios are special variants where if you miss once, just once, your run will end. This forces you to be consistent, smooth, and perfect in your technique. We can see here how these motions are still quick, but they're all performed the same way. There is barely any wasted motion. Underflicks and overflicks are so small and fixed so quickly that they become barely noticeable. Let's compare this run to that of another older player. Banana FPS. I show this gameplay quite often because it shows what happens when players over-rely on speed and perform their flicks too drastically. The result is a shaky landing, and a ton of wasted motion made in an effort to decelerate quickly onto the target. Most importantly, we can see how each next motion is different from the last. This is because of how hard Banana FPS is focusing on flick speed, which means he has to have much higher tension to decelerate. When we look at Snowy, it's an entirely different appearance. The best descriptor for Snowy's aim is that it looks calm. Calm aim is beneficial because it helps you to learn tension management and have much more controllable motions. And by the way, if you want to have calm looking aim, you guys should try my new specialty tea released by Mana Potion Coffee, the Sharpshooter, a peach black tea. That's right guys, I'm now partnered with Mana Potion Coffee Company. and I have my own aimer tee. Check out the cool sharpshooter design on the back. It's me in fantasy aimer form. If you want to try my new tee, head over to www.manapotioncoffee.com or click the link in the description. Remember to use the discount code Maddie to get 15% off every purchase. Every sale of my tea, I get a portion of the profit. So if you want to support me, definitely go check it out. Trust me, guys. My scores went up after drinking this. As we were discussing, this is what sets Snowy's aim apart. If we compare his bounce 180 runs with mine, which one looks more consistent to you? Which one looks cleaner? Without a doubt, it is Snowy's. Imitating this kind of aim is, in my opinion, the key to good consistency in aiming technique. But how exactly do we imitate it? Copying Snowy's technique requires an understanding of why it works. Let's look specifically at dynamic clicking, since that is the category where most, if not all, proper aiming factors and strategies can come together. One of the problems we might encounter with trying to go really fast on dynamic clicking scenarios like bounce 180 is that it becomes increasingly difficult to keep track of multiple targets' movement. We aren't able to stay several steps ahead of ourselves anymore because we're simply moving through targets way too quickly. As a result, it's a lot harder to make adjustments to our pathing based on our peripheral vision. Our view of targets in our peripheral vision is blurred by the intense speed of flicks. Give some thoughts as to how motion clarity affects our aim. Imagine playing aim training with intense motion blur. Many gaming monitors can suffer from ghosting issues, but imagine that the ghosting for these runs specifically is 10 times worse. This is what can happen to our peripheral vision when we flick too fast and dynamic clicking. The loss of smoothness coincides with the loss in perceptive ability. This is the primary reason why aiming like Snowy is much better in dynamic clicking. To do it, we have to withhold our flicks and make them look intentionally less snappy, so that we give ourselves ample time to read bot movements. For obvious reasons though, this may be considered too slow. This is where pacing comes in. Developing a steady, consistent rhythm of hits is the best way to measure how fast we need to be in dynamic clicking. Another way to look at Snowy's technique is to see it as the polar opposite of the MBM technique. We know that the MBM technique relies heavily on full flicks, speed, and brute force runs with little movement reading. Snowy's technique is all movement reading, and it prioritizes smoothness and accuracy. Good scenarios to practice this on are the following. Air, no UFO, no skybots. You want to focus on edge tracking and reacting smoothly. Passive small reload. Again, calmly aiming and reading the entire map rather than just individual targets. Bounce 180, the original scenario. Accuracy scored. Focus on withholding your flicks and maintaining a high accuracy. If you want, you can try never miss variants of static and dynamic scenarios, but these are very tough and may induce mental agony. When we try to make the in-game translation from aim trainers, it's important that we consider where these different techniques and strategies for different categories fit in, or if they don't fit in at all. For example, we know that edge tracking is not the best reactive tracking strategy to apply in-game, but where can we find good use in smoothness and withholding flicks? A good point to remember with Snowy's aim is that it allows him to see the entire map of the scenario clearly. That is, the smoothness with which he aims makes it easier to process the movements of multiple targets instead of one. It is anti-tunnel vision, where the clarity allows him to more easily multitask or process the movements of singular targets faster. Salzy is a very smooth Valorant aimer. To be a good aimer, not everyone needs to prioritize flicking and speed like Tens. By nature, techniques that overfocus on speed will be inconsistent. Salzy's aim, though, is quite consistent, and his gameplay is a good example of how to leverage calm, smooth aim. An example in Overwatch would probably be this recent gameplay by the Korean pro player, Prophet, who is visibly confident in aiming smoothly by leveraging his knowledge of Overwatch strafing. Relying on flicking technique when playing Widow can certainly get you some really flashy kills, but it is once again inconsistent. Instead, the better way to play Widowmaker is to read the movements of your targets and react cleanly to them. The same idea can be seen with VT Honor, Dezio, who leverages his precision in tracking and movement reading skills to hit very consistent shots. If you study Snowy's VODs and practice mimicking his smooth motions in the aim trainer, playing calmly and reading your opponents will become much easier and more effective than taking gamble flicks. We can see the same kind of style in Snowy's own Overwatch gameplay. This completes our dive into who I think is a severely underrated aim training player with severely overlooked ideas on aiming technique. Once again, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video or aim bot. Be sure to follow my Twitch and tune in for streams of aim training or Overwatch. As always, happy dot clicking.